It is what gives me energy, what gives me hope, and actually all of you and the children fill my bucket. Yay! So I can't imagine not doing it. Yay, there you go. out of the mouths of one of our peace kids. So what we'd like to do today is start with the kids who are part of our peace circles. But I just want everyone to know that we have really expanded our work, and we have been doing a lot of work with people at the McKenna Center who are returned citizens. We are working in N Street Village, where we have women who are in recovery, and also in jails and prisons. And it's amazing how everybody is longing for these tools and these practices. So with that, the way it's been happening is that Little Friends for Peace expanded its staff, because Jerry and I said alone we can do something, but together we can do great things. So I'd like Katie, who's on our staff in development, where are you, Katie? Come on up here. And Shoa, who's our program director, come on up. So they have helped make LFFP be what it is.
Well, I want to thank everyone for coming out and continuing to support LFFP, and we're so happy to see all your faces, and we hope that you enjoy the show and that you're enjoying your time here. Thank you.
And also want to thank everyone for coming out. I know last year we did at Plus Boys and Poets, but I think this is a great location, and we're excited to see everyone's talents.
Thank you. And we are turning a lot of our the work over to these young people who have such great ideas. So they are the ones who pulled this together. Allison and Kristen, where are you? And Tracy's not here, but all of this committee has been meeting, and they've done a fabulous job with the raffles and pulling it all together. So let's give them a big hand. I guess they're all in the back. So on my right is Rob, who found us online. And you know, teaches and comes twice a week after school to teach some more and guide people around on this path to peace. So Rob, thank you for being part of LFSP. Okay, so the last thing I want to say is that someone else who's been one of our teachers, some of you have met her, Peace Camp, and that's Hillary Horn. And many of the people from Arlington could not be here today because her husband is on the last days of his life. So I would like to have us all have a moment of silence for Rich, who has been a peace builder, peacemaker, especially for our environment. And Hillary wanted to be here today along with our other circle in Arlington, but they are around his bedside right now. So let's have a moment of silence for Hillary and Rich. Would all the peace kids that are here, that have been part of Peace Camp, the little up to anybody that wants to come up to help start the program with our Peace Pledge. Come on, Renaissance. Come on up. Awesome. world.
Everybody pause to look at this beautiful world. What do we want for our world?
Peace.
All right, so we're going to put it down. So we do this with our big people, our little people, and then you say, do you want to plant the pole? Okay, what do we say? Everybody say
peace be with our earth.
All right, great job. Okay, and girls, you want to put your ball? Okay, so should we start? Let's put our hand on our heart.
Your heart, baby.
All right, let's go. 1, 2, 3.
Peace-filling flesh. I am peace-builder. I pledge to talk to others with respect, to treat people with care, to make peace not break peace, to build peace at home, at school, and in my neighborhood each day.
All right, let's do our song.
My head is in the sky, sky, sky. My feet are on the ground, ground, ground. And what about my blood? It's from the sea. And what about my bones? Like the mountains be. And my
evening, a warm welcome, and I want to greet you all in peace. Tonight, I'm reading a poem that talks about the peaceful and another about the conflict balance. But the peaceful is to remind each and every one of us about the importance of spreading the word for peace, and the symbolic nature of the peaceful is to remind us all that peace is better than war. Anywhere you find this peaceful, war shall never lend its toll. For this may seem a rare story ever told by peace lovers of old. We must all strive to plant peacefuls in every corner of the globe, so that war shall never be bold in the face to confront this mighty peaceful. Like prayers that ward off the devil, whenever it's said in the midst of evil. War shall never be brave or bold in the comfort and serenity of this mighty peaceful. And every seed of peace we sow in the globe will surely grow with a peaceful. The second poem is a reference to my home country in Sierra Leone, where conflict diamonds helped to exacerbate the war and created a lot of problems for many people instead of blessings. So the title of the poem is For Your Sparkling Brilliance. For your sparkling brilliance, they formed an unholy alliance. They rebelled, revolted, ganged up, bought arms, chopped arms. They formed an unholy alliance. For your sparkling brilliance, they sent you as a precious stone, leaving thousands of precious innocent souls, destroying them in their wake, and leaving in its stake blood, scars, and bones. For your sparkling brilliance, you were sent as an attachment to our ears, glittering those shiny faces. But when your sparkling brilliance brings joy and happiness, and your sparkling brilliance is not a conflict diamond, does not bring in its wake tears, fears, calls, blood, and bones. This beautiful gemstone, in this country where it has naturally grown, will be all my own, and I shall proudly own. Thank you.
To be able to step into this room and away from some of the craziness that's going on outside of here, and to be able to listen to some really talented people, and we're going to continue that right now by calling up Jasmine Elizabeth White, who is also going to be reading some poetry.
Miss MJ and Mr. Jerry, because they've been like parents to me. So yeah. Being in the mind of a youth, taking the back burner of the truth. I wish to be a part of the change where all hands can connect and live as a community. But how can it be started without peace? And without the essence of warm embraces and listening ears? It is not time that can't change, but action. Wisdom is only a factor, but vision is the only prosperity. With that, I truly believe that Miss MJ and Jerry Park deserve a Family Nobel Peace Prize. Congratulations on your 35 years of peace. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be able to speak as strongly as I have today, loving others and changing.
Well, I think we can all second that sentiment. MJ and Jerry for a peace prize.
Well, I don't know about that, but I know that Jasmine has been, it's been amazing, Jasmine, because she's had some hard times. Her road hasn't always been easy, but just like we know, peace is not easy, but it's beautiful. And she has stuck it out, and she's really now guiding lots of kids. Last summer, I think you did 3 peace camps, and she stayed after, and we did circle. So it's amazing what being in peace camp and peace class. Thank you, Jasmine. You really touched my heart.
All right, so we have a little change to the schedule right now. We're going to have a different act than is what's listed on the program. But if I could invite Devin and Savannah, they are going to be singing a song.
Hey, what's up? What's going on, everybody? My name is Devin White. I'm a singer and performer. I had the pleasure of meeting MJ a little while back now, and actually was able to start coming into some of the classrooms or workshops and like working with the kids and talking about our dreams and aspirations and what it takes to get there. So I just wanted to share one of our records, and I hope you guys enjoy it. It's a little more up-tempo. I know everyone's kind of sitting back and relaxing, so don't feel any pressure. I'm just gonna be up here in my little zone. We're ready, E, thank you. This song is called Adore You. Hope you enjoy it. Turn it up for me.
Come on!
Thank you so much. Thank you. MJ, just once again, as well as show, and thank you so much for bringing me a part of this. MJ, I'm inspired every day seeing you and what you guys all do for the youth that come. And I think that what they gain, I think, is beyond words. And so I'm just so thankful. Thank you so much.
Devin in action with the kids. Comes to Perry School, gets them all up on their feet, gets peace in action, gets them to express themselves. So we are honored to have you now officially a part of the LFFP family. Woo!
For their dancing. And as they do that, we are going to start with a few raffle prizes. So if I could also have Kristen come up to the stage. All right, there we go. So So this first prize is for a 10 class pass here at Joe's. Okay. So big prize. Okay. Timmy's got it. Should we get a drum roll? Let's get a drum roll. It was really excited for the winner. Our first winner is Ziana. Very excited. All right, first winner of the evening. All right, our next prize is the Finding Dory lunchbox. And this goes to Shanika Jackson. Our next prize is a pair of speakers. And there's only a last name, but Roar, J Roar. There we go. Hey, come down from the back. Okay. And we got one more. Okay. These are for the handmade piece items. And the winner, I don't know if I trust this or not. Tommy Park. Oh, if he's not in the building, he doesn't get it. Okay, all right, I guess we can give it to MJ.
If you saw those beautiful handmade piece things, they were made by Kristen's grandmother in New York, sent them here. Beautiful.
Okay, we will continue the raffle later, but right now the Renaissance Cultural Center, I believe, is ready. So I would like to invite them up to the stage.
Hey, Black Child, do you know where try to learn what you can learn. Hey, Black Joe.
You know you're strong.
Really, really strong. Do you know you can do what you want to do? And tomorrow, your nation can be what you want it to be.
This definitely isn't a competition. No offense to anyone else who got on the stage, but that's a hard act to beat. All right.
Rose, come here. She came to peace camp when she had just arrived from Cameroon. And I can just see her at the Mount Rainier peace camp, all over the place, and trying to find her way. And her mom, Elizabeth, where are you? She's guiding all the kids. She came in the back to pick them up, and she was just newly arrived. And now Elizabeth's leading Renaissance Cultural Center, collaborating with Little Friends for Peace, and these two young girls are now being CITs and junior counselors, helping other kids to dance. And those who don't know about Peace Camp, this is why we love it. Because every day we get to celebrate the gifts of the kids and we see what's possible and it lifts us up. So thank you.
And it will be another dance performance by Carmen Malapudi.
The tune of Celia Cruz. I don't know how many of you know Celia Cruz. It was from Cuba. She passed away and she came to the States and Fidel Castro wouldn't let her go back even when her mom died. So it was really sad for her. All her songs are very profound. The one I'm going to try to dance to is titled Life is a Festival. And I'll tell you the words to it because you will not understand it because it's going to be in Spanish. So I hope you don't mind. If you get bored, stop me and I'll stop translating the song, okay? So it goes like this. Everybody that thinks that life is not fair or unequal has to know that it is not like so. That life is a beauty and one has to know how to live it. I have a hard time pronouncing the I's and the E's and the E's, so. Everybody that thinks that you are all alone and that you are not doing well, you have to know that that is not so. That in life there's nobody who is alone, but there's always someone around. One cannot cry because life has to be celebrated like a festival. It is more beautiful to live singing than crying. Life is a festival, and all our sorrows can go away singing. One should not cry, because life can be a festival, and it is better to sing than to cry. Everybody that thinks that life is always true has to know that it is not like so, that there are only some bad moments, and everything passes. Everybody that thinks that things are not going to change has to know that everything passes and when something bad happens, you put up a good front and a good face. One cannot cry because life should be celebrated. It is better to live singing than crying. Life is for laughing, not for crying. Life is for enjoying. One is better to sing than to cry. One has to be singing and not crying. Everybody that thinks that life is really cruel will never be alone because God is always with us. For those that complain,
for those that criticize, for those that make war, for those that contaminate the earth. You're going to see a part of the song that goes boo, boo, boo. She's booing the people that do all those bad things. Basically, that's the song. I'm going to ask you if some of you wouldn't mind joining me, and I will lead you.
Thank you.
With the dance. If anybody wants to join me, you're more than welcome. If not, I'll just do it alone.
It was nice to see everybody get involved. A lot of volunteers on that one. We are going to invite up another performance by the Renaissance Cultural Group. So if the second act could come on up.
Thank you.
training. And this is S-Roar. Susan Roar. Hey, there we go. Okay, this is New York Knicks year. This is the peace bag, and the winner is Susan Roar again. So you got a peace sweatshirt and a peace bag, all peaced out. This is for the, is this for the Rangers? Okay, so for the Rangers hockey stick, and the winner is Tommy Park. Again, Tommy. All right, we are going to have one more performance. If I could have MJ to the stage real quick. And actually, if I could have Whitney come to the stage. Forward. mostly outside and hasn't been able to see a lot of the performances. So thank you for all your work. Okay. So next prize we're drawing is
the DC United ticket.
Ooh, DC United tickets. Those all say my name, right? All those tickets? Those are mine? Okay. DC United tickets is Kenneth.